This short video has been put together by Greater Manchester Fire and Rescue Service. Its aim is to tell you about our Safe and Well offer and what you can do to help the people within the community who are at risk of fire.
Our data tells us that whilst fires have reduced over recent years, some people are still having fires, and those people are likely to be known to health and social care services. Those at increased risk of fire are often your service users.
This slide shows you the profile of the people who we know are most at risk of fire.
Our main prevention tool used to be a home safety check. We've now changed this to a safe and well visit. You're now going to see a short film which will tell you all about the safe and well visits.
Over the last few decades, the fire service has changed. Back in the 1980s, firefighters attended a lot of fires and other incidents. We did an excellent job of dealing with those fires and rescuing people. As we worked through the 90s, we were very successful in getting people to fit smoke alarms in their homes. As a result of this, many fires were detected faster, meaning property damage and loss of life were reduced. We didn't stop there. In the new millennium, we started visiting people's houses, not to just promote smoke alarm ownership, but to educate people on how they could prevent fires occurring. And we went to lots of homes and met lots of people. By 2010, we came to understand that older people were more vulnerable than others. So we focused our attention on these people. As we approached 2015, we identified a clear relationship between our risk groups and those prone to slips, trips, falls, and ill health. So what's all this leading to? The answer is Safe and Well. Safe and Well aims to improve the health, well-being, and safety of the people in our community. From the usual fire safety advice to health interventions such as falling hazards or providing safety equipment. But why are firefighters expected to start doing this? Firefighters are trusted and respected in communities and have access to vulnerable people that other agencies just don't have. This unique access allows us to address problems directly and do more of the all-important prevention that we know works so well. And it doesn't stop there. A strong Safe and Well strategy helps our colleagues and partner agencies, reduces workloads on health services, saves public money, and above all, keeps people safe in their homes and communities. So, keep an eye out for more updates from us over the coming months as we continue to keep our residents safe and well. Thanks for watching.
Most fire and rescue services have adopted Safe and Well visits. Here in Greater Manchester, our Safe and Well visit not only includes fire safety advice, but also we ask questions about health and well-being.
The reason we ask about people's health and well-being is because sometimes this can affect their risk of having a fire. For example, memory impairment, alcohol use, mobility problems, and the sedative effect of medication can all be relevant when we do a fire risk assessment.
During our Safe and Well visits, we have the opportunity to signpost and refer people to services that may be able to help them improve their quality of life.
The next slide tells you what we can cover during the Safe and Well visit.
We will now show you how to make a referral to Greater Manchester Fire Rescue Service for a Safe and Well visit.
I'd like to say thanks very much for watching that video, we really appreciate it. If you would like any advice on Safe and Well visits, please contact Greater Manchester team. We can arrange for a member of our team to come visit you, or alternatively, you can come to a staff meeting and we can further discuss our offer of Safe and Well visits. Thank you very much.